Hello and welcome back to your own channel Indian Defense Analysis, where we bring to you all the latest development happening in the defense sector.
Netra is the unsung hero of Balakot strike and air skirmish followed after that. The next day, when F-16 combat jets of Pakistan Air Force attempted to violate the Indian airspace, it was indigenous AW&C which alerted MiG-21s and other fighters on air patrol about F-16s, resulting in a dogfight between MiG-21 and F-16. Back in September 2021, the Cabinet Committee on Security (CCS) cleared a mega project of 6 new Made in India airborne early warning and control aircraft AW&C worth rupees 11,000 crore. These AW&Cs will be built on Airbus 319S or A321 aircraft to be provided by state-owned Air India. The six AW&C Block 2 planes would be highly capable than their predecessor Netra plane. The best part of the project is that it is to be built on existing aircraft provided by Air India, which means India don't have to buy the platforms like Airbus 330 and save good amount of money from its already starving defense budget. Air India will be transferring 6 aircraft to Indian Air Force soon and it will be sent to OEM for refitments. Center for Airborne Systems, CAPS, in charge of developing 6 airborne early warning and control system, has said that all 6 Netra Mk2 will be handed over to Indian Air Force in next 6 to 7 years period. Netra Mk2 will also provide more than 240 degree coverage, but CAFS refused to confirm at this point. However, it's expected to provide coverage of 270 or 300 degrees. It will be equipped with a scaled up variant of AESA that was previously based on Netra Mk1. The scan range and tracking capabilities of AESA radar bound for Netra Mk2 will be more than double than what is on Netra Mk1. Since A319 is a bigger platform than ERG-145, radar can be packed with more transmit and receive module and more power can be derived from bigger engines to meet additional power requirement of the scaled up radar. The Netra Mk2 is expected to have range in excess of 500 km and will be able to detect less observable targets such as drones and stealth fighters. Now, there has been some changes in the new Netra AW&C. DRDO's A319 aircraft, which is flying testbed for Netra Mk2, is also known as Anushandhan. Back in August 2021, DRDO has completed all the ground trials of indigenously built maritime AESA radar, and there are plans to conduct its air trial in which its flight performance will be tested. But before that, all the electronics and avionics system need to be installed in Anushandhan, which includes air surveillance radar, SATCOM, data link, comm antennas and other sensors. For this purpose, DRDO has issued a fresh tender for the installation of electronics and avionics equipment. However, we have seen a lot of fundamental changes in Netra Mk2 from what was showcased during Aero India show. In the latest tender document issued by DRDO, we have seen many fundamental changes in Netra Mk2. We will be comparing Netra Mk2 displayed in Aero India 2021 with the images shared in the latest tender document. The first visible change is the position of IFF surveillance radar or dorsal plank. In the model displayed in Aero India show, the dorsal plank is seen in the stern or rear of the plane. It has been now moved towards the mid of the aircraft. The second visual change is in the radar at nose cone. The Netra Mk2 displayed in Aero India show a weather radar at nose cone. From the image shared in tender document, it seems to be shifted at the top of fuselage at the visible blister. This should allow a much larger array and simplified looming. It is going to be derivative of indigenously developed Uttam AESA radar. As per the initial design which was showcased in Aero India show, the beyond line of sight data links was planned above the frontal nose section, but now it has been placed close to the tail section of the plane. It will incorporate two radars. They are synthetic aperture radar and gallium arsenide based triple AU Mk2 radar. It will have multiple communication antennas to communicate with different frequency band in order to avoid channel overlapping. plan to cube Netra MK2 with maritime AS radar has been dropped, and new design does not have maritime AS radar, which was planned at the bottom of the plane. Now the bottom section will have synthetic aperture radar for bottom view. However, as per some claim, the bottom section will have electro-optical targeting system (EOTS). A forward-looking infrared search and track system can also be seen in the lower mid-forward fuselage section in the tender document. It can also be an advanced electro-optical targeting system (EOTS) system. The sapphire window-like design seen suggests that it could be EOTS system similar to one in F-35 fighter jets. These changes will be incorporated in Anusandhan, followed by developmental trials of the aircraft, which will start in next 4 years. Netra 2.0 will incorporate SATCOM data link, identification of friend and foe system, electronic countermeasure system, self-protection suit, chaff dispenser, and dual auxiliary power unit.
This was today's update. Please let us know what is your views about these in comment section. Feel free to post your comments and suggestions about any topic related to defense sector on which you want to hear from us. With this, I would like to say goodbye and Jai Hind, friends. Please like and subscribe our video if you have not done already. We'll be soon back with more interesting and amazing development happening in defense sector.